Hello and welcome. Today we are going to program a timer. First we need to include a library called standard library. This allows us to use a function to clear the screen after we print the data out. Now let's make a function called printData so we can use it later. XD. Before we print anything, we should always clear the old data printed on the screen using the system clear screen command. In order to make the command prompt user friendly, we need to make a menu to guide the user. The user will need to enter a number to select an option. \n means new line. After the user select an option, the data need to store somewhere. Because we are using the printData function outside of the main function, we will write the variable outside is called global variable. Flag is for later use. We will need to print the time on the screen using %d to represent the data as integer. In other word, whole number, each d represent the variables sequentially. Let's run this program and see. Oops, forgot to call the printData function xd. Oops again, forgot to put \n. Now we are good, gee guys, no problem. Just need to put some colons to separate the time. Nice, we are good. So now, we need to create some delay for the timer. In order to do that, we use a time library. Void means the function will not return any value after we use it. Clock_t is a data type for the clock function, is similar to integer. Both works the same way with memory size of 4 bytes. The clock counts the time in millisecond after you build the program. It starts from 0 and keep on increasing. You'll see in this while loop condition, the time delay is set from the old clock value plus the input millisecond value, and because the clock will keep on increasing, it will eventually be greater than the time delay, so the while loop condition returns false, and then end the function. If you don't understand, it's easier to see if you can try the code separately, put any value into the delay and wait. Let's put 1000 milliseconds into the parameter, which is 1 second. So it waited for 1 second, and then printed the data. Nice. To make things more complicated, I will teach you not to use scanf. We will need to use a new library called coneo.h, which means console input output header file. Now, it's time to make the counter. This is an advanced technique to collect user input using interruption. KB hit means keyboard hit is used to detect whether the user press any key on the keyboard. Because we cannot use Boolean in C program to return true or false, we will use the flag variable we created from earlier. Let's say when the flag is equal to 0 to keep the loop running. So the while loop will only continue if nothing is pressed and the flag is 0. In other word, if any key is pressed, the condition is no longer true, so it will interrupt the while loop and stop. This can't be accomplished by scanf, because we don't want the timer to stop counting and wait for the user to enter any key. To count the time, if minutes is greater than 59, then we will reset it to 0 and put 1 to the hour, because we are counting from 0, so we don't want to include the number 60. Same goes to seconds. After we finished detecting the carrier for minutes and seconds, we can use the printData function to update the information on the screen. Putting the printData function before the delay and incrementation can allows us to display zeros on the screen, so we don't need to start at 1 and miss the zeros. Clever, isn't it? Haha. You can see the second is increasing, but is a bit too slow. Let's change the step size so it can go faster instead of 1. Let's do 30. but the digit is carried to the next one. Now we need to create the selection, so that the user can select different function to control the timer. This is another hard and important section, so be sure to listen carefully. Like I said, let's make things complicated for not using scanf, we'll use getchar instead, haha. Getchar means get the character. By put it into a switch case, so that we don't need to use many if statements. Here comes the important part, my friends. On our keyboard, each key is linked with a number. If we want to select that key, we will need to know the number behind it. Let's say the number 1 on your keyboard, the number behind it is 49, and number 2 is 50, and number 3 is 51, and so on. You can use the key code table to find out the detail. I will post a link in the description, so you can use it next time to make new keys for control. In the printData function, we declare 1 to start, so by setting the flag to 0, we can keep the while loop inside the counter running, and we declare 2 to stop, setting the flag to 1 makes the while loop condition goes false. For 3, we reset all the data stored inside the global variables, so that everything becomes 0 again. Also set the flag to 1 to stop the timer from counting. Finally for 4, we use exit to end the program. Return 0 will not work on here. If you don't believe me, you can try. XD. Now the selection is done, we can put it inside the counter, just after the while loop with keyboard hit, to collect an input from user. Let's run it, is counting, for to end. We need to put the counter inside a while loop, so that it won't end after the user enter an option, while 1 means it will always true, so the loop will never end. Stop is working, but the reset doesn't seem to work. Oh, I forgot to add print data inside the select for reset. Now we are talking. So this is it. I hope you learned something, and enjoy programming XD 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 ha ha ha.